मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सो इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग डिस्कस अबाउट न्यूटन सेकंड लॉ एंड अरिस्टॉटल एंड वर्सेस न्यूटन अप्रोच. सो न्यूटन सेकंड लॉ स्टेट्स दैट द फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन अ ऑब्जेक्ट इज इक्वल टू द रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम, दैट इज डीपी बाई डी टी. सो दैट पी इज लीनियर मोमेंटम, दैट इज अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ मास एंड वेलासिटी ऑलरेडी नो. सो जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट यू विल गेट दैट मास इज कॉन्स्टेंट, सो इट्स टेकन आउट, देन डीवी बाई डी टी. सो डीवी बाई डी टी इज एक्सेलरेशन, द चेंज इन वेलासिटी विद रेस्पेक्ट टू टाइम. So force is equal to product of mass and acceleration. And force and acceleration always in the same direction. For example, an object have a mass m. I am applying a force in this direction. So the object moves in the same direction with acceleration m. So force and acceleration acts in the same direction. So according to Newton, force need not cause the motion, but only a change in motion. So force causes only a change in motion. So that is the idea behind that Newton. So unit of force is Newton. So to honor the scientist Newton, the short form capital N. So there is a change in momentum in an object, so there should be a force acts on a body. Then if an object have acceleration, there should be a force acts on a body. And also there is a change in velocity acts on the body, so there should be a force acts on the body. So these two are the two forms of Newton's second law. Then one Newton, so define one Newton. So just using this formula, one Newton is equal to 1 kilogram into 1 meter second power minus 2. So one Newton is equal to force acts on 1 kilogram of mass, that 1 kilogram of mass gives the acceleration 1 meter second power minus 2, acts in the direction of force. So already I told that force and acceleration acts in the same direction. So 1 Newton force is equal to 1 kilogram of mass, that force acts on 1 kilogram of mass, that 1 kilogram of mass is accelerated to 1 meter second power minus 2 in the direction of force, that is 1 Newton. So that Newton's second law is valid in inertial frame. So if it is a non-inertial frame, there should be some modifications in the formula. Then Aristotle versus Newton's approach. So Newton's second law gives the explanation for that inclined plane experiment. So an object moving in an inclined plane. So Aristotle told there is a need of force to move an object with constant velocity, but Galileo told there is no need of force to move an object. If an object is moving in an inclined plane, there is no need of force. So that's two are contradictory. So Aristotle, so there is a need of external force to move an object with constant velocity. So the net force is, that is the external force. But according to Galileo and Newton, so there is no need of external force. So the external force acts on a body, but there should be a frictional force acts in opposite direction. So in normal cases, frictional force is not negligible. So the frictional force acts, so the force acts on the body, the object moves in this direction, but frictional force acts in opposite direction. So that frictional force reduces the velocity of an object and bring back the object to rest. So that is the work of that frictional force. So the object, that is external force, acts on the body, then frictional force acts in opposite direction. That frictional force reduces the velocity of an object and bring back to rest. So that is net force is equal to zero. So because the external force in this direction, frictional force in opposite direction, then the net force is zero. So there is a zero net force acts on a body when it moves with constant velocity. So this is the idea of Galileo and Newton. So what is the drawback of Aristotle? So he didn't consider the frictional force. So he think like that, so there is an external force acts, the object moves for a small distance, after that it stops because there is no external force acts on. So the force here, the object travel a small distance and stop because there is no force acts on the object, then only it stops, because he didn't consider that frictional force acting on an object. So in this class we will discuss Newton's second law, that is force acts on an object is equal to the rate of change of momentum, as well as that is a product of mass and acceleration. Then Aristotle versus Newton's approach. So here there is a need of external force to move an object with constant velocity, but here Galileo and Newton's approach, so external force acts on a body, a frictional force acts opposite in direction, that frictional force stops the object. by reducing the velocity and stop the object. So the net force is zero. So okay.